I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous chapter, we saw how algebra can be used to solve problems involving mixtures of solutions. In this chapter, we will see how to solve problems involving other types of mixtures. Adrienne Seienstein has taken a part-time job managing her Uncle Monopolis's coffee shop. The shop sells two different types of roasted coffee beans at two different price points. Their very expensive Tasmanian roasted coffee, hand-picked by specially trained wombats, sells for $31 per pound. The shop also offers an inexpensive coffee, roasted at the White Sands Nuclear Testing Range, for $3 a pound. Adrienne thinks that a moderately priced coffee might appeal to a broader group of customers. She decides to mix the two types of coffee beans to create a special blend costing $10 per pound. To do this, Adrienne must calculate the quantity of each type of coffee bean needed to create a pound of coffee costing $10. As we saw in the previous chapters, this problem can be organized by creating a table. In the first row of the table, we will list the price per pound of each coffee. We know that the Tasmanian coffee costs $31 per pound. The White Sands Nuclear Roast costs $3 per pound. And the blend we wish to create must cost $10 per pound. In the second row, we list the weight of each coffee to mix to create 1 pound of coffee blend, which costs $10. If we let X represent the weight of the Tasmanian roast, then the weight of nuclear roast must be 1 minus X, since the combined weight of Tasmanian roast plus nuclear roast must be 1 pound. In the third row, we will list the total cost of each coffee, given the price per pound and the weight. The cost of the Tasmanian roast is $31 per pound times X pounds, or 31X dollars. Likewise, the cost of the nuclear roast is $3 per pound times 1 minus X pounds. Since the combined cost of the two coffees in the blend must be $10, we can create an equation which says that the cost of the Tasmanian roast plus the cost of the nuclear roast equals $10. We can now solve this equation for X. We start by distributing the 3 to the two terms in parentheses. We can then multiply 3 times 1 and eliminate the parentheses. Combining like terms, we subtract 31x minus 3x to get 28x. Subtracting 3 from both sides of the equation allows us to cancel the positive and negative 3s on the left, leaving the equation 28x equals 10 minus 3, or 28x equals 7. We then divide both sides by 28, allowing us to cancel the 28s in the numerator and denominator of the fraction on the left. This leaves us with the equation x equals 7 over 28, or x equals 1/4. So to create 1 pound of a $10 per pound blend, Adrienne must mix 1/4 pound of Tasmanian roast with 1 minus 1/4, or 3/4 pound of nuclear roast. We can check our calculations by multiplying the price per pound for each of the two coffees times their calculated weights and check to see if the total cost for a pound of blend comes to $10. The cost of the Tasmanian roast in 1 pound of Adrienne's blend is $31 times 1/4 pound. And the cost of the nuclear roast is $3 times 3/4 pound. Multiplying 31 times 1/4, we get 31/4. And 3 times 3/4 is 9/4. Adding these two fractions, we get 31 plus 9/4, or 40/4, which is equal to 10. Since the total cost of the calculated amounts of the two roasts is $10, our calculations appear to be correct. Our next example illustrates how algebra can be used to solve problems involving mixtures of items selling at different prices. The YU Entertainment Committee is planning a concert of the world-famous bagpipe quartet, Alistair, Ian, Angus, and Clyde. The concert will be performed at the Y University Concert Hall, which seats 1,000 people. Normally, tickets sell for $50 a seat. However, to be sure that the 1,000-seat auditorium is completely filled, the committee has decided to offer a number of discounted tickets at $30 a ticket. The total revenue collected from ticket sales must be at least $45,000 in order to cover the cost of the performance. The entertainment committee therefore needs to know how many discounted tickets can be offered and still collect $45,000, assuming that a total of 1,000 tickets are sold. Fortunately, using algebra, we can calculate how many discounted tickets can be sold and still collect $45,000. Once again, we can organize this problem by creating a table. In the first row of the table, we list the ticket prices for discounted and non-discounted tickets. In the second row, we list the number of discounted and non-discounted tickets which will be sold. If we let X represent the number of discounted tickets, then the number of non-discounted tickets will be 1,000 minus X, since the total number of tickets is 1,000. In the third row, we list the revenue generated by each type of ticket, given the ticket price, and the number of tickets sold. The revenue produced by the discounted tickets is $30 times X tickets, or 30X dollars. Likewise, the revenue produced by the non-discounted tickets is $50 times 1,000 minus X tickets. Since the total revenue generated by both types of tickets must be $45,000, we can create an equation which says that the revenue from discounted tickets plus the revenue from non-discounted tickets is equal to $45,000. We can now solve this equation for X. We start by distributing 50 to the two terms in parentheses. We then complete the arithmetic in the parentheses, multiplying 50 times 1,000 and eliminate the parentheses. Combining like terms, we subtract 30x minus 50x to get negative 20x. And subtracting 50,000 from both sides of the equation allows us to cancel the positive and negative 50,000, leaving the negative 20x term alone on the left. Completing the arithmetic on the right, we subtract 45,000 minus 50,000 to get negative 5,000. We then eliminate the coefficient of x by dividing both sides by negative 20, allowing us to cancel the negative 20s in the numerator and denominator of the fraction on the left. Finally, dividing negative 5,000 by negative 20, we get x equals 250. So 250 discounted tickets can be sold, and 1,000 minus 250, or 750 non-discounted tickets can be sold. We can check our calculations by multiplying the ticket price for each type of ticket times the number of tickets, and check to see if the total revenue comes to $45,000. The revenue from the discounted tickets is $30 times 250 tickets, and the revenue from the non-discounted tickets is $50 times 750 tickets. Multiplying 30 times 250, we get 7,500. And 50 times 750, is 37,500. Adding these two numbers, we get 45,000. Since the total revenue from the calculated quantities of discounted plus non-discounted tickets is $45,000, we know that our calculations are correct. In the last several lectures, we have seen how to create linear equations to solve various types of real-world problems. In the next few lectures, we will explore algebraic methods which we can use to create parallel and perpendicular lines.